Hi friends, I'm just preparing CCIE routing and switching. So I like to share the preparation question to you. This is with a set of some CCIE routing and switching questions with answers. There is no more explanation on this. The explanation on each questions I will describe you later. So who are interested or you are preparing the CCIE routing and switching, please have a look on this video and try to prepare these questions. Who already took the CCIE routing and switching, please make sure that these questions are valid. Please comment, post your comment in the section who are taken CCIE routing and switching recently, and you can help the others to make sure that the question is valid, because I am not sure that question is still valid or not, because this is old dumps. I searched a few PDF through internet and I got collected from my friends. I got 4 to 5 PDF files, 125 question, 195 question, 340-50 question, 300 question. So just each video we are going to see the 15 to 20 questions, okay? And you can post your comments, explanation, or whatever you have queries, please post your comment. I will try to clear your queries, or even others who are can join this community and make use of it, and you can respond that whether the question is valid or not. So based on that, it will helpful others to clear the CCIE routing and switching. Okay, now we will directly go to the dumps. See, as per the diagram, there are three routers. There is R1 is connected to R2 and R2 is connected to R3. R1 and R2 is running with YSPF and R2 and R3 is running with the AHRP. Okay, now the question is, refer to the exhibit which two configuration in R2 could cause R1 to produce the given output. Actually, what is the output means? Output is showing that 192.68.3.0 segment, right? You can see that 192.168.3.0/24 learning via 12.2. 12.2 is R2, which is connected towards R1, right? Yeah, then that is 3. Segment is a R3 router, so R3 router is learning to R1, so the AHRP is redistributed into YSPF. So the question answer correct is, what are the command is exhibited in R1 to produce the given output? So it's a redistribution, so you have to execute this command under the router YSPF and redistribute AHRP 23, that is redistributing AHRP 23 with metric into 110 subnets. The subnets command is necessary when you are redistributing into AHRP. So this is, and why it is E1 type, because it is not specifying that you are specifying the metric type also. So it's a E1. So this 2 is right. Sorry, there is a no. It's simply showing YSPF, so you are not changing the metric type. So this is the right answer. You can either give this command with the subnets and without subnet also. So this is the right answer. D and E is the right answer. Okay, we'll go to the second one. We'll quickly run through the question and answers in this section. Okay, refer to the exit you have configured R1 to connect to two different ISP, which allows remote user to access host A through both ISP, which is Cisco IO security, which can be configured on R1 to drop a request from the attacker A. So you have to, this attacker A, that is 192.168.2.1 segment, should be dropped. It will be considered as attacker. Here they are given as a, it's coming from outside the network. So what command will restrict that one? So URPF strict mode, because URPF strict mode, that explanation you can see it in later. Okay, which option origin code when the root is distributed into BGP? Okay, which option will be is if you are redistributing any root into BGP, redistribution root always show incomplete, right? It will cover under BGP attributes. How long will root bridge continue to send BBDU to notify bridge to edge out their MAC address? So it will be plus forward delay and plus maximum edge time, that is a 15 plus 20 seconds. So it will wait for that forward time and maximum edge time to get over before removing the MAC address table, MAC address from the table. Okay, which two methods can use to limit the range of EAGRP queries? You want to limit the range of EAGRP queries, so which two method? So you can see so many options are given. The answer is C and E, that is summarize routes at the boundary routes of the EAGRP. You can specify by the summary address command and stub routers. This is stub routers, here it is specified as a right address, leave that. If you configure that as a stub router, the EAGRP query will be limited. Okay, which two options or purpose of MSDB? SCA filtering. This MSDB used to improve the scalability of MSDB multicast environment, and the other one will be to reduce the number of multicast addresses that are shared to MSDBers. So I'm not giving any explanation. So who all recently taken or who are interested to explain, you can post your comment so that others can know about that particular technology. So this video is posted to helping each other. Okay, we will continue the next question. Okay, which two factors contribute to traffic starvation when TCP and UDP flows are included in a single traffic class? Okay, the answer is the TCP flows continually lower the transmissions when congestion occurs in the link. The other will be UDP flow. Okay, the TCP will lower the congestion. Okay, then reduce the number of multicast address to star MSDB peers. Sorry, it's got stuck up. TCP flows continue lower the transmission rates when congestion occurs on a link, and UDP will maintain a consistent transmission rate when congestion occurs on a link. Okay, which option is implicit access rule for IPv6 access list? So permit neighbor discovery, deny everything. So IPv6 implicit access rule will be permit the neighbor discovery, then deny everything. For which feature in the address family RT filter used? Root target constraint. Okay, that is already specified, it's RT, so it is a root target constraint. So the question number 10, refer to the X bit. What happens to your TCP packet that is received on interface JIG 0/0/0.1000, which has TF bit set to 1 and packet as a valid destination? If you are receiving any packet, TCP packet in this sub interface, what action will take? Okay, we can see the route map configured with the permit 50 match IP address list 1, you have a specific IP address, the set IP into TF0, that is a one route. Okay, if you are getting any TCP packet, okay, deny TCP any, the IP list 1 is created to deny TCP any, the rest of the things it will permit. That was called under a route map to set a IP TF equal to 1. But here you are receiving the just TF bit set to 1. So what? And the packet has a valid destination. You have a route. What it will do? So the packet is not matched by the route map FOO, because FOO route map is not matching that, and the TF bit is left as it was. So it will not change the TF bit. Okay, because that is the answer. How can you protect a device from DOS attack directly against its terminal and management ports? So you can create a maximum login attempts command on the terminal and management port, so the denial of service attack can be restricted by restricting the login attempts. Which three elements compose a network entity title? So that is a area ID, system ID, and an SCAP selector. Okay, Then question number 13, which two OSPF network type require the use of DR and PDR? Okay, where the DR and PDR election will take place? Okay, the DR PDR election will take place in